Good morning, everyone. Welcome to Ben and All Parts Facebook page, and welcome to all of our YouTube subscribers. Last week, we did a little short video talking about the next project we've got. It's the 327 small block, 327 small journal out of a 65 Corvette, matching numbers block. Kind of highlighted this engine came from Thibodeau, Louisiana. So we're proud of the fact that the man drove 525 miles to get here to drop this engine off. Just a little history on this. He had this engine built at another shop somewhere out there where he lived. He picked it up and made it just a few miles, and it started having some issues. Some rock arms jumped off and different things. So. It started knocking and it did a little internal damage. At this point, we're not sure how much damage or where the damage is, but so we're going to start disassembling this engine. We're going to kind of do a video of as we go through the teardown and so let you see as we take it apart and start making a diagnosis of of the issues that we find with it. So we're going to call this Wednesday teardown. Okay, Wednesday teardown day. So we're going to get this, start getting this disassembled, and as we go through each of the little steps, we might just talk a little bit about what we find with this component or that component. But hopefully by the end of the day, we'll have this thing down to a bare block. We already know the crankshaft's not any good. Customer has actually, when he brought the engine, he brought us another crankshaft, so we've got that machined and ready to go. So we're that much ahead of the game with the crankshaft. We're more worried about the valve train camshaft stuff. We'll make sure that that's good, and above all, the biggest and the most important component of this is making sure that the block is good. We hope there's been no damage to the block, so we'll know shortly. So we're going to highlight this for you today. We'll get it out there on our Facebook page by the weekend, hopefully, and kind of let you and, of course, let the customer see, because he's watching from Louisiana, real anxious to find out what's going on with it. So with that being said, we're going to go ahead and get started. Appreciate you tuning in this morning. We hope to have this disassembled and finished up sometime by today or first thing in the morning, and we'll have that video out there for you to take a look at by the weekend. So thanks again, and look forward to seeing you next time.
Gumbo John was a swamper, he had a small cafe. Little old shack just outside of Baton Rouge. Everybody around said you had it made, if you were looking for the right kind of food. You just kick back and let the evening come. Out on the back porch at Gumbo John's. Me and the boys and the band were needing a break. We were covered with road dust and the homesick blues. So we decided to starve and spend a few days, peel a few crawdads and check out the brew. Southern culture on the skid, but it sure is fun. Out on the back porch at Gumbo John's. Gator named Clyde out back in a little stream. He said, boys, he's a friend of mine, but he's still real mean. He said, you know, I used to play the guitar myself. He held up his hand, just had two fingers left. It was feeding time one evening, he'd had a few beers. Guess he got just a little too close, caught one chomp, and old Clyde, he ended his musical career. But he could still rap back and sing that jolly blonde out on the back porch, Gumbo John. Oh, you just kick back and let the evening come out on the back porch, Gumbo John.
All right, welcome back once again to Benny and All Parts, Benny Auto Parts Facebook page, and all of our YouTube subscribers as well. So we're calling this Teardown Wednesday. We've gotten the 327 that came over from Louisiana. We're tearing this engine down right now, and so we've basically got the top end of the engine disassembled. Heads are off, all the valve trains off, camshafts out of it, the timing sets out of it. So far, the lifters and all look good. Camshaft showing a little wear on it. Don't know what kind of camshaft he had in it. Customer stated to us that it was way too much camshaft. So we're going to kind of check that out. We've agreed on a camshaft that the customer wants to use. So we're already settled on that. But what I did want to show you before we flip this thing over is we found on number one piston right here, as you can see on number one, something has been on this piston, has gotten on top of it. Looks like it struck right here, kind of indented a little bit, and it, whatever it is, just kind of rattled around. Now, the customer, in talking to him, he stated that the two rocker arms on number one cylinder had come off and were lodged under the valve spring itself. But I took it apart, I looked at those rocker arms, and I checked the push rods. The push rods are all straight, the rocker arms look good, the nuts are tight. Don't know yet if it's been any valves. We're going to check that, but got the heads right here. So this is the cylinder heads. This would have been number one right here, and I don't see any evidence that the valve touched the piston anywhere. Let's look at this one here. So all that looks relatively good. Somebody's put the big valves in it. Looks like it's got the, looks possibly got 202.16 valves in it already. So that's a good thing. So don't see any evidence that a valve touched the piston, but you know, proof's in the pudding. You know, this is as far as I've gone, and you can definitely see that something got on top of that piston. Foreign object, washer, small screw, anything like that, I don't know. I don't know if it's done any damage to that piston or not, but we're gonna go ahead and turn it over. We've got the camshaft out of it in the front right here. Camshaft's out of it. All this is taken off. So this gear right here is gonna come off, but if you'll notice, if David can zero in right here, so he definitely had a problem right here. So it spun out this keyway. Balancer is either was run loose. I suspect it was run loose, didn't have a bolt in it. And then it also, when it did that, it kind of spun out right here too on the front of this crank gear where the keyway is. So that spun off and gone. That one spun off and gone. Of course, when they did that, it's just wallowed out this keyway. So basically, this crankshaft's not any good anymore. So, but the customer knew that. He was aware of that. And he's gotten us a crankshaft already. We've taken care of that. We've got it ground and ready to go. So anyway, just want to kind of give you a real quick overview of what we've run into so far. What we found, just to be honest with you, I haven't found a whole lot of damage yet. Everything looks relatively good. The only thing that concerns me is what caused this, and I don't know if it's collapsed the top of that piston or not. You know, I'll know once I pop that piston out, I'll look at the ring gland and see if it's collapsed or not. So that's not usually good when you got something dancing around on top of a piston. Possibility it got under the valve as well. Of course, if it got under the valve, it may not show it on the head looking at it visually, but there's a good chance it probably bent that valve as well. So anyway, that's where we're at on this thing. Just want to kind of bring you up to date real quick. We're going to spin it over and get the oil pan off of it, get the oil pump and screen off of it, and then continue on with our disassembly and our further evaluation so we can make a diagnosis of what direction we want to go. So thanks for tuning in, and we'll get this finished up, and we'll be back in touch in just a little bit. So thank you very much. Pump's not lost up, that's good. This is the oil pump drive shaft. The distributor locks into the cam gear and it spins this shaft. This is what turns the oil pump. That looks good. Pull that in there. So, when it came from the factory, it didn't have a cartridge. It didn't have a spin-on oil filter. It had a cartridge type deal. And this one has been adapted over to use a spin-on filter right here. So this little piece here is made by Mr. Gasket, and it converts it over to a spin-on filter. I've used these before. I actually prefer a different brand than this one, but you know, if you get one that seals good, you're good, but a lot of times it's hard to get these things to seal. Your demo, you got this one sealed pretty good. So. See, it's got the check valve and all built into it. It just sits down in there and bolts up. It's a good unit. The problem with these units is this O-ring right here is hard to seal. This is a square O-ring. And sometimes you've got this one glued in pretty good. So maybe it wasn't leaking down here. That's a good thing.
that's that. You see, it does have the, so this bottom part right here, this is what came in it from the, when the motor was built from Chevrolet. This is a check valve right here in it. And then this sits down in there, then this sits on top of that and seals it off. Got the two bolts holding it in, and then you're able to use a spin-on type oil filter. This particular model used the old number was a PF25. The new one is a Wix 51061R or a 51061 regular. So that's the spin-on filter that we use now.
Welcome to Benny and Auto Parts Facebook page, and welcome also to all of our YouTube subscribers. So yesterday we talked about the 327 that we were going to disassemble from the fella in Thibodaux, Louisiana. Cajun fella, real nice talking guy. I love listening to him. So he brought this engine over, drove 525 miles to drop it off with us to get it rebuilt. So we're going through the processes. Yesterday we got it completely disassembled. So here on this table you see is all of the parts and pieces we took off of it. Of course, this is his intake manifold. This is a era correct for that 65 Corvette 327. It's a winner's type intake manifold. Oil pump, took out of it, head gaskets, customer's camshaft, a distributor, Zelt's manifolds, new timing set that he's brought. All this is what we have disassembled and taken out of the engine. Got it here, got a stage up on this table to start getting it to the processes of getting it cleaned and getting it ready to go back together. So that's a process that we'll be working on. Once we got the engine apart, the block, thank goodness, Mr. Customer in Louisiana, your block is good. Couldn't find any cracks in it. Got one little suspect on the front main. It looks like it possibly at one time tried to spin a front main bearing. We're going to check that real close for him, and we'll probably do the line bore on it, do a line hone. Torque everything in and check those clearances on that when we get ready to reassemble it. But other than that, the block turned out reasonably good. Now, I'm a little concerned about the block. At one time was stamped that it was 30 over, but we mic'd the customer's pistons that we took out of it, and they're micing it 40 over. So we've got the block down in the block department now. We've got it in the vat, getting it a real thorough cleaning, getting all the grease and stuff off of it. Then we're going to do a good Magnaflux to make sure we don't see any cracks in it anywhere, any little minute little imperfections that might could possibly lead to something that could be disastrous down the road. So we always check all that when we get started. So we're gonna do that. We've got the heads down. The heads look good. Customer had stated to us that a couple of the rocker arms had come off. Well, we looked at that real close when I took the rocker arms off. It actually had brand new rockers on it. Had new push rods in it. Push rods all rolled straight. The rocker arms look good. They were new. Springs look good. So I couldn't tell if it had, it possibly could have been a valve or anything, but I couldn't see it. But we will, as we get into that and get it disassembled, we'll check all those valves and make sure that none of them are bent. We'll go through the heads totally, make sure he's got the correct springs on there. It does have performance springs on it already. So we'll check that. What we're interested in those heads is figuring out at an installed height of 1 inch 800, 1 inch 750, where we're going to be as far as what our installed spring pressure is. We're typically looking for, on the cam that we're going to put in this thing, we're probably looking for somewhere between 100 to 105 to 115 pounds on the seat. So that's what we'll be shooting for on the heads. So if you'll switch right over here, this is the pistons we took out of it. So the oddest thing I saw, and this again was on cylinder number one, where the customer indicated that's where he had the issue. So you can see on this piston right here, something has gotten on top of this piston and has struck it right here. It's kind of messed the metal up a little bit, and it kind of danced around. I don't know if maybe he was trying to find top dead center. For some reason he did this, I don't know. Doesn't appear the piston is damaged. It didn't collapse the ring groove at all. These are Federal Mogul Seal Power hyper-eutectic coated skirt pistons. Got the factory small journal rods in it. Rod bolts have not been updated. This has got the little 11/32 rod bolts and nuts in it. So we're gonna update these. We're gonna put a set of ARP 3/8 nuts and bolts in it. So we'll update these. We can get a much better clamping pressure, and we can, you know, these only torque to like 26, 30 pounds. The new ones, when we put the ARPs, they'll torque in about 45. And you know, these things over the years, I'm sure they've stretched and they're out of tolerance. So we're not even gonna take a chance. Now, one thing I did notice that the engine had been balanced. So it did a nice balance job. All the rods were weighed up good. The unfortunate thing about that balance job is crankshaft's no longer any good. So it was already 2020 when I took it out. The balancer at some point in time had come off of this engine, and when the balancer came off, it destroyed the keyway. So it basically, that basically rendered this crankshaft, you know, useless, not able to use it, because you can't really fix a keyway. I guess you could, maybe somebody could in the old past days could weld it up and cut a new keyway, but customer, that's really immaterial. Customer's got another crankshaft that he picked up off eBay, and we have it. As a matter of fact, we've already grounded it and got it ready to go back in. Of course, we'll have to rebalance everything, which is not a problem. We'll definitely rebalance it. So that's where we're coming on that. So let me show you a little bit about these bearings. So as you can see, all these pistons are just, they're just real smutted up. I mean, it's real, the whole engine is running really, really rich. Got a lot of blow-by down here. You can see the blow-by. A little scuffing going on right here. So I don't know if this was a fresh bore. The engine was supposedly just been built, but it shows signs of not being bored. Again, at some time it was bored, but I don't think it's been real recently bored. So anyway, that's our pistons. All the pistons look good. Other than that, we're gonna clean them up real good. Maybe we can reuse them, we're not sure. One of the main concerns that I found is this is the rod bearings out of it. Of course, we use, and this guy did too, he used tri-metal rod bearings, Clevite P-Series bearings. This was a tri-metal bearing. So as you can see, a lot of these bearings are down to the copper. Okay, so tri means three metals. The top layer of metal is gone, pretty much, and we're down into the copper, which is the second layer of metal. So then this is an indication right here. When you see this on the thrust side of the rod, when I say the thrust side, I mean the rod side, not the cap side. It indicates had too much timing in it. So somebody had the timing way advanced. That's generally what causes this. So a little bit of concern there on that. We're gonna work with that. All of the rod bearings, here's number, I think this is number 1, 2, 3, 4. So here's a rod bearing out of number 4. Shows the same thing down to the copper. You can see it right there, copper showing. Not a good thing, again, too much time in. And that was pretty consistent, all 8 of them. All 8 rods showed that copper on the bearing. So that tells me that camshaft timing was way off, or they couldn't get it to run without putting a lot of timing in it. When I say a lot of timing, I'm probably talking about, you know, probably base timing 20 degrees and probably, you know, total timing probably over 40. That's generally what causes that. So we're gonna check that. Main bearings that came out of it. Main bearings have had a lot of trash run through it. You can see the main bearings here. They're just all scuffed up and scratched up. A little bit of thrust issue. So this is the back side of the thrust main. And you can see it has got a lot of wear on it for some reason. Thrust in the crankshaft, well, I checked that thrust before we pulled it out. The thrust actually was probably, 50, 60,000ths thrust in it. In other words, the thrust of the crankshaft is the actual movement of the crankshaft frontwards to backwards. So factory spec on that is probably 5 to 8 thousandths is what the factory recommends. You know, this engine was, 40 or 50,000ths moving back and forth. So that's not a good thing, but that's immaterial because we're not using that crank. We've got another crankshaft. So once we start assembling that, we'll check his thrust for him. So everything else is pretty decent. We'll start assembling this again. This is another one of the rod bearings. You can see it, copper showing. Then this was the thrust side. In other words, it's the top bearing in the rod, showing all that copper. Again, product of incorrect timing. So where's where we at? We've got this thing total disassembled. We've made a diagnosis analysis of what we got to work with. So we're gonna proceed now. We're getting the block all clean, checked the MagnaFlux, make sure there's no cracks in it. We're gonna check our bore, see where we're at on a bore. Like I said, pistons are micing 40. Not sure where the block is at this point. We're gonna mic the block and see after we get it all cleaned and see where we're at on the block. Crankshaft. We've got another crankshaft. We've already gotten it ground for the customer. It is a steel shaft, Small General 327, which by the way, this engine is going in a 65 Corvette 327 four-speed car. So that's what it's going back in. So the heads are in the head department. We'll start working through the heads and getting all that checked and cleaned and make sure it's all good. We'll do a complete rework on the heads. Got to check those valve springs to make sure they match the camshaft the customer's picked out. So one of the things that stuck in my mind with Mr. Customer from Louisiana is he told me, he said, I want a gentleman's Corvette. So I said, okay, tell me what you mean by gentleman's Corvette. He says, I don't want it real erratic idle. I want it where it's very drivable. I want to get in it, to leave the house and go wherever I want to go and not worry about getting back. He said, I don't want a lot of jumping and hopping with the camshaft. And one of the issues he had with this build here, whoever did it, is it had way too much camshaft in it. So he wants to tone that camshaft down a little bit. Even though it's a four-speed car, he wants something that's just got a little bumpy idle, but looking for an RPM range of 1,000 to 5,500 on the camshaft. So that's kind of where we're going to put it. He and I have already looked over different camshaft combinations. So we have picked that. We settled on a combination. He's got the part number. It's a comp cam. It's going to be a comp cam. So we're going to do that, get the comp cam for him, and we'll get everything, start getting everything cleaned up and get it ready for reassembly. So he's entrusted us to do the build for him. We're very privileged and very pleased that he's showing a confidence in us to take care of this. I mean, drive 525 miles, that speaks a lot for Benning Auto Parts and the type of work that we do. We're not a mass production engine shop. We do one at a time. We build one engine at a time. We check everything. We spec it out. We check bearing clearances. We check ring gaps. We go that little extra mile. And I think it shows on our videos that you guys have been watching on Facebook. So again, today, that's where we're at with the 327. We got a lot accomplished yesterday, got it completely tore down, but got a good diagnosis of what was going on with it. So we got a direction now. So we're gonna head that direction. Gonna get everything ready to go for the customer and getting this back reassembled for him. So after we get this engine reassembled, it is one that we're gonna crank and run on the engine stand. So once he comes to get it, it'll be run, everything set to specs, timing, valves, everything will be ready. Just basically what he'll do is he'll drop it in, put his carburetor back on it, hook up his transmission and various lines and hoses and stuff, but it should be ready to start. Timing to be set, distributor to be in place. So thanks for tuning in this morning. Just wanted to get you up to date on this build that we're doing. We're excited about it, and I think it's going to be a really nice build. I love building the old 327, especially for a nostalgic, you know, 65 Corvette 327. You don't get any more nostalgic than that, in my opinion. So, again, thanks for tuning in, and we'll get this out this week so everybody else can take a look at it. And then hopefully next week we'll have something else for you. Maybe we'll be ready to start the reassembly. So thanks again for joining in.